Hello everyone, this is Professor Pawan Shonkar and I welcome you in the 44th lecture of Machine Design and Drawing 2. And in last lecture, that is the 43rd lecture, we have started numerical on piston. So let us complete same numerical in current lecture. So we have calculated a width of ring from top land and then the second width, that is the width of second successive ring, that is B1 and B2. So after that, next part is gap between free end of ring. Gap between free end of ring. What does it mean? Suppose this is a pressure ring or the piston ring. So we are talking about this gap. What will be the distance between these two end when it is a free ring? And second gap will be then when that same ring is in a cylinder. So that distance again get reduced because it is get compressed somewhat. So these two gap we will find out here. So gap between free end of ring when it is not in a cylinder. So and it is given by G1 equal to equation is 0.002D to 0.004D. Okay, so let us calculate this gap. 0.002 into 100 to 0.004 into 100. So gap is in between 0.2 to 0.4. Sorry, Okay, so this is a G1, and what is a G2? G2 will be the gap between a end of ring when it is in cylinder, inside the cylinder. So G2 is gap between ends when ring is in cylinder. When it is moving inside the cylinder, it is get reduced. That gap is get reduced because ring will compressed in some proportion. So for G2, the equation is actually we have calculated here G2, and for inside cylinder, by mistake I have written here equation for G2 actually. Okay, so this is not the for the free end, gap between the ring when it is inside the cylinder. I am writing here when it is inside the cylinder. So this is your G2, and now we will calculate G1 for free end. When ring is not in cylinder, so G1 equal to 3.5 T1 to 4 T2. 4 T1. Okay, so this will be 3.5 into T1 is 3.4. 2. 4 into 3.4. So G1 has a range of 11.9 to 13.6. 11.9 mm to 13.6 mm. Okay, so this is your G1 and this is G2. This is again in mm. Okay, I repeat, G1 is the distance between free end of ring when it is not in the cylinder, but when it goes in a cylinder, that gap get reduced by some proportion. So G2 for the gap when it is in a cylinder and G1 is the gap when it is not in the cylinder, it is a free. Next part is number 3, piston barrel. We have discussed here before what is barrel, scored, okay. For cylinder, the whole sleeve is a cylinder barrel, and for the piston, same concept is applied. So piston barrel, for piston barrel we will calculate thickness. So maximum thickness of barrel, maximum thickness of barrel, so maximum thickness of barrel is given by T3 equal to 0.03D plus T1 plus 4.9 mm. Okay, so let us put up the values. So 0.03 into 100 plus T1 is 3.4 plus 4.9, so T3 become 11.3 mm. So this is the thickness of piston barrel. Now piston wall thickness towards open end. Now see, piston is this, like this is a piston, okay. So this is a open end, this is a closed end. So towards open end, what is the thickness, wall thickness of piston, that we will calculate here. So piston wall thickness, piston wall thickness towards open end is given as T4. So T4 equal to, equation is 0.25 into T3 to 0.35 T3. So T4 becomes 0.25 T3 is just calculated 11.3 to 0.35 into 11.3. So T4 is 2.8 to 3.9. Okay, 2.8 to 3.9. So we'll choose just middle value, that is a 3.4 mm. Okay, exact mean of this. So this is your T4. Next is a piston skirt. Piston skirt means this whole length, this complete portion. So this is a piston skirt. So and you can say length of piston is a piston skirt. So this length we'll find out here. So piston skirt, suppose L is length of skirt, okay. So and side thrust, that is R on a cylinder due to strength, is given by, let me erase it. See here, side thrust due to, side thrust R due to strength is given as capital R equal to 0.1 p small p into area, that is pi by 4 d square. Side thrust, that is a resultant force, okay. So force is pressure into area, but that standard equation is 0.1 times the pressure into area. So 0.1 into P into pi by 4 d square. So putting the values, so R equal to 0.1 into P is 5 gas pressure into pi by 4 d square, that is 100 square. Okay, so we get value here, force is 3928, and as it is a force, so unit is newton. Okay, now side thrust due to gas pressure, R equal to, equation is PB into D into L. Okay, so put up the values now. 0.45 into 100 into length is unknown, that length is to be calculated here. So we know the values of side thrust R, and R has the equation PB into D into L, where PB is again a pressure. Okay, so L equal to R, that is 3928 by 0.45 into 100. So length will be 87.3. So standard we have taken or considered here 90 mm. Okay, so this is a length of piston skirt, but again this is the length of piston skirt. We need to find out the total length. So now total length, for total length L equal to capital L equal to length of skirt small l plus in bracket, see the equation carefully, NR number of ring into T2 bracket complete plus NR minus 1 into B2 bracket complete plus B1. Okay, now put up the values properly. So L is 90 plus in bracket NR is 4 4 into T2 is 2.5 plus again NR is 4 minus 1, B2 is 2.5 and bracket complete plus B1 is 18. Okay, we have calculated B1 width from top land for the first ring, and B2 is a width for second successive ring. So complete or the total length we got here as 129 mm, or taken as 130 mm as a standard. Okay, so this is our total length for the piston. Okay, now the next parameter for the piston design is number 5, piston pin. It is also known as a gudgeon pin or GON, gudgeon pin. Okay, so piston pin. Now for piston pin, maximum load on piston due to gas pressure. Obviously we are calculating load here, so load will be stress into area or the pressure into area. So load is given as area, that is pi by 4 d square, obviously into pressure, so pressure into area. Okay, so put up values here, pi by 4 into d square, that means 100 square, and the pressure is taken as gas pressure, that is 5 newton per mm square. So we'll get here maximum load on a piston, and that is 39275. Okay, so we have calculated load here. Now load on a piston due to bearing pressure PB, but load on piston due to bearing pressure that is PB is given as, load is again pressure into area, so pressure PB 1 into area is DO into L1, diameter into length. This is only for the piston, okay, load on piston, because so DO diameter for the piston and length of piston skirt. So putting the values, PB1 is 25 into DO piston, diameter of piston is unknown here, and length L1 is as 0.45 capital D. So put up values, 25 into DO into 0.45 into 100. So only DO will be unknown here, so 1125 times DO, but the load is already calculated here, maximum load on piston due to gas pressure, both load are the same, so we can equate this and this, so that DO, that diameter, can be easily calculated. So equating 39275 equal to 1125 into DO, so DO equal to 34.9 mm or say 35 mm. Okay, so this is the DO. Now the inside diameter of pin is usually taken as what we have calculated here. DO is outer diameter of pin. We are doing calculation for piston pin. Okay, so inside diameter of piston pin, inside diameter of piston pin has a relation, DI is 0.6 times DO. Okay, this is a standard value or the standard relation. So DI equal to 0.6 into DO is 35, so inside diameter is 21 mm. Okay, and the last part for the piston design is maximum bending moment at the center of the pin. Maximum bending moment at the center of the pin. So maximum bending moment is given as M equal to W into D by 8. Okay, so load is 39275 into diameter is 100 divided by 8. So maximum bending moment we are getting 491 into 10 raised to 3 Newton mm. But bending moment has a standard equation. We have seen that in case of a shaft design. So maximum bending moment equation is M equal to pi by 32 sigma b bending stress into DO raised to 4 minus DI raised to 4 by DO. This is for hollow shaft we have studied. Okay, so we are considering same equation for the pin. So pi by 32 sigma b, that is a bending stress, outer diameter of pin, inner diameter of pin. Okay, so putting the value of m, 9491 into 10 raised to 3 equal to pi by 32 into sigma b, that is unknown value, outer diameter we have calculated here, 35 raised to 4 minus 21 raised to 4 divided by 35. So bending stress on the pin can be easily calculated here, 134 newton per mm square, or you can say 134 megapascal, okay, or 134 megapascal. So this is a bending stress on a piston pin. Okay, so induced stress on pin we got as 134, but the standard value for the piston pin for given material is around 140 megapascal. So we can comment here, since induced bending stress, induced bending stress in the pin is less than permissible value of 140 megapascal, so design is safe. Okay, hence design is safe. Okay, so we have completed here this numerical. As you can see, we have conducted two lectures. We gone through the two lectures to complete a single numerical. So that much length this numerical has. Okay, I hope you are getting this numerical. Prepare it. Probably you need to prepare bearing numericals, because of the numerical on a piston is very vast, as well as connecting rod numericals are very vast. So as this is a part of your syllabus, that's why I have completed. But for the exam purpose, you need to concentrate on bearing numericals probably. Okay, so thank you. We are stopping here. Thank you.